Hey guys, it's Denise from lemonhead.com, and this time we're going to knit a case. And what's super cool about this project, you get to use up some of that scrap yarn. Hey, watch the video completely before starting the project. Alright, let's grab the first color and we're going to work with one strand of yarn. So secure that to the anchor peg and a simple knot will work just fine. And then we're going to do a drawstring cast on. So we're going to zigzag every other peg. I think I said that wrong. Yep, meant to say zigzag. Alright, now place your yarn flat across the pegs and we're going to knit only the ones that have two loops of yarn. It's easier for me to just work a couple of pegs at a time, so I'll place it flat on, you know, four or five and then move on to the next. When you get back to the front of the loom, you're basically going to ignore that first peg and just place your yarn right over that one, which is going to take you then after you do these next two knit offs. What you're going to be doing, passing that one into the next one, is that you're starting your first row. So just continue knitting, and you're using the U-wrap version of the knit stitch. So you're going to half wrap your peg and knit off. And after a few rows, I just want to make sure that you don't forget to remove that knot. I would say after the 3-4 rows. Then when you're ready to change colors, just cut the working yarn and grab the next color. And you're going to do a simple knot. So you're just like wrapping one around the other and then, you know, tying a knot. I call it a kindergarten knot. And you could change colors after, you know, your yarn is finished, or in my case I was doing about 5 to 6. Then take that knot and push it down as close to the peg as you can and do a second knot if you want to. I prefer to do that, and at that point you could just keep knitting. And now you're just gonna keep knitting and keep knitting rows and changing colors as you like. And keep in mind that for me, it was 6 rows for every inch. I happen to have done 45. That was enough for my pencils. It's going to look a little short until you stretch out your stitches. At this point, you're going to look for the half point on your loom so that you can do your bind off. In the case of my loom, it's peg 12. And so we're on to the basic bind off. Let's go ahead and knit off that first peg, and now we're going to knit peg 2. This is done over 2 pegs, and after the knit off you're going to move loop you're going to move the loop from peg 2 over to peg 1, tighten and knit off peg 1, and then take that loop off of peg 1 and move it over to peg 2. From this point on, you're only going to knit the second peg, which is the next one over. So knit off, take your loop and move it from peg 2 over to peg 1, tighten, knit off, and then you're going to take that loop and you're going to move it from peg 1 over to peg 2, and that's how you're binding off. Continue with the same process. Knit peg 2, take your loop off of peg 2, put it on peg 1, tighten, knit off peg 1. And now you're going to take that peg 2 and move it over. And just keep going until you bind off 12 pegs. And as usual, I didn't pay attention, and so I had to move my mark over after I did count those 12 pegs. So, you know, stuff happens. Now you're going to need to take the loop on that little corner and bring it up and place it on the peg next to it. Now that was the first loop that you did the bind off on, and what that's going to do is kind of tighten this bind off so that it looks neater. So after you put that loop on, you're going to go ahead and knit off, and then you're going to come to the other side and you're going to do the same thing with you know, this peg. All right, now let's go ahead and knit off. All right, well now we're gonna knit flat, so you're gonna skip that first one, and then you're going to use again that U-wrap knit stitch in order to knit four rows flat. And flat just means that you're not going around in a circle. You're going to go back and forth on those 12 pegs. Your loom might be larger, and so you may have more pegs. Now, when you reach the end of each row, you're going to turn around and you're going to skip that first one or slip it and knit off on peg two. That's going to leave you a little like loose loop right in between these two pegs, one and two. So you're going to pick that loose loop up and you're going to place it on the second peg. That's just to keep your edging like really nice and neat, especially if you have a large gauge loom. It's kind of hard to get that loop to look neat. So at this point, just knit off, and then you're just going to continue knitting a total of four rows, just remembering to do pick up that loose loop every time you reach the end and you turn. When you're finished knitting those four rows and now it's time to turn around, you're going to slip the first knit off on peg two. Of course, bring that loose loop on and place it over on peg two and knit off that second peg. And then we're going to do something a little different. We're going to do purl stitches. So for that, bring the working yarn under, create a new loop, take the old loop off, put the new one on, and pull again. Scoop up and create a new loop, take the old one off, put the new one on, and pull. And keep doing that. You need 8 purl stitches for this row. All right? And once you finish knitting those 8 purl stitches, that's going to leave you with 2 more pegs at the end. And those 2 pegs, you're going to do your regular U-wrap knit stitch. Then, just as before, you're going to knit 4 rows flat. Once you finish knitting those 4 rows, then you're going to look for the middle. For me, it's here. I have 12 pegs left over, so really it's these 2, but I got to pick one, so I picked this one and not this one. So I'm going to go back to the beginning, and just like before, I knit off peg 2. Take the loop in between over and knit off in order to clean up my edging nicely. And then I have a few more pegs to knit before I reach my, I'm going to call it semi-middle, since it's really 2 pegs would be my middle. But again, once I knit off that last peg right there before I reach the peg I chose as my middle, when I get to it, I take the loop off that peg and I'm going to move it over. Now, this would be a knit 2 together yarn over, but I'm going to do things a little different. It's okay. It's my project. I can do that. So I'm going to take my yarn and I'm going to place it flat over that peg and knit off on the peg next to it. And knit off on the one before it. Here is where my buttonhole will be. And then I'm just going to keep knitting that row until I get to the end. Because guess what? After we finish knitting this row, we got to turn around to knit 4 more rows. Thank you. All right, it's time to bind off those last 12 pegs. So finish knitting your row. So there's your knit off, and now you're gonna knit peg 2, and we're doing the basic bind off. We just wanna clean up that little edge, so we're gonna bring that loop from the middle, knit off, and now we'll take loop off peg 2 and put it on peg 1. I think you guys know the routine, but we'll do a little bit. Knit off, move, loop from peg 1 over to peg 2, and you're going to knit off. And again, you're going to wrap peg 2, knit off, and you're going to move the loop from 2 to 1. You guys know the drill. Alright, you've reached the end of your bind off, and so you're going to take that last loop, and after you knit off, just get your scissors and you're going to cut that working yarn. And you can go ahead if you'd like, and you could just pull that out. It's going to leave you a loop that's a little loose. Just take the end of that working yarn and feed it through. We're later on going to fix that a little better. In the meantime, you could start off by stretching your stitches, and you know, some sections might feel a little different than others. Don't worry about it. There's your buttonhole, and we're going to make that a lot prettier. So don't worry that some of it looks kind of crazy because you're not done yet. So in the meantime, just make sure that you stretch all of your stitches, and we're going to fix that. So we're going to feed it in. It's going to look really nice. Now find the working yarn from the cast on, and we're going to start pulling from the opposite direction on those really loose loops. And you don't have to do this. You can sew this together without doing this, but it's going to make it a lot cleaner and a lot easier. If pulling on these is a little too hard, then just grab the working yarn and pull on it, and it will on its own tighten up these loose loops. I just kind of like to help it along. That's why I start from the other end. And again, the objective is to tighten up those loose loops so that when we go to sew this side, it will look better. So get a yarn needle and thread it with the working yarn, and then take your project and put it inside out. Make sure the needle is on the other end. And let's start sewing. Try to do this as neatly as you can, but don't get fixated. The objective is just to close the end. What I try to do is, if I can see an opening, oh, by the way, make a knot, that I just feed the yarn needle through those openings. And if I feed it through and I feel like there's still room to feed it through again, I'll do that. I'll feed it through that little hole twice, so that when I take the project and put it back to the front, I don't see any holes in the bottom, and I don't want any of my tools or my pencils or anything to fall out. So as you can see, I see that there is an opening there. I'm going to feed the working yarn through that little hole 2 times before I move on to the next one. Work all the way to the very edge, and then we're going to kind of pull a loop out in order to use it to make a knot and secure that. And then you could just, you know, cut that working yarn so you don't have that. And you can cut off the other yarn so that it's kind of neater inside, even though it's not going to get seen, but you don't want it to get hooked on any of your tools or pencils or anything. I'm not cleaning it up right now, not to use your time watching me cut more yarn. All right, now we're going to fix this top part. Like I told you, that loose loop that is right there, just feed your needle through the one that's right next to it, and that's kind of tightening it up already. And I'm using the working yarn that was already attached. It was part of this flap, and all I'm going to do is just feed that working yarn through a couple of the side loops, and that's really going to clean it up pretty much. You don't have to get carried away. Just do enough that it makes you feel comfortable, and then you could just get a, you know, get your scissors and cut that excess yarn and hide it in there. Now it's time to put a button. Grab a small piece of the working yarn, and we're going to fix this buttonhole first. You don't have to do that, but I think it's going to look way, way, way better. So if you want to make it nice and neat, let's do that. And as you see, I fed the working yarn, and then I make a knot. All right, now we're going to basically wrap the loops that are around this buttonhole. And it's just basically that. It's just wrapping the loops in a circular shape. And you're going to be amazed at how much nicer your buttonhole will look if you just take the time to do this very simple sewing technique. And like I said, all you're going to do is look for the loop and wrap that loop. So you're coming from the top in and then just come right back out again. You see that? One more time. I'm going to slow this down for you. So here it goes. As you see, you just take your needle and find one of your stitches, like right here, and come from the outside in, and then just wrap that surrounding area. And when you're done, you just go to the other side, find a loop where you're going to feed that working yarn, and you're going to create another loop to help you make a knot. And basically, you're done with your buttonhole. Now all you have to do is clean up all those loose ends by cutting them off. And go ahead and turn your flap down so you can figure out where you want your button. Like for me, it's right here. And you're going to try to get that button high enough so that it stops that top from rolling down. See, I'm going to put it right there, and I'm getting a needle that's going to fit the little holes in the button, and I get a little piece of the matching yarn. Mine is 4-ply, so I'm going to unravel it and take two plies out of the 4 and feed it through my thin needle. It is an embroidery needle, by the way. And that's going to allow me to feed through these little holes in the button. So bring your needle up, and you're going to leave one end of it there available to you so that you can make a knot and secure your thread. Okay, so your button doesn't just come off. And then you're going to sew this a couple of times to make sure that it's secure. For me, depending on the hole, maybe 3, but at least feed your yarn through these little holes at least 2 times. And after you're done with feeding them through all your little holes, then come back to the inside of your project, and you're going to create a knot with the other end of your thread. And I will normally do 2 knots because I don't want this to come off after I finally put it on. And here we go. Then all you got to do is get your scissors and cut off the excess thread. And guess what? You're done. Your project is done. But good idea to block this project. All right, there you go. Now what I need you to do is tell me how you're going to use your case. Here's one idea. How about 4 glasses? And I hope you like this. Like it if you do. And if you haven't already done so, subscribe.